So this video is about compound interest. So you have seen previous about simple interest. Now simple interest to compound interest, I'll tell the difference. At the same time, we'll see the problems that relate to the compound interest and when the compound interest is calculated quarterly or half yearly, annually. So different ways we can solve the problems. Now apart from these problems which I'm explaining in this topic, if you want some more solutions of your textbook questions, you'll find the website here. In this, you can see the link also in description below, or else you can type. So in this website you'll find out more papers, model papers, test papers and question banks, including a video class also from 6th to 12th. So all the subjects are available. So this video I make especially for class 8 students of ICSE board. Now other boards also available here. And subscribe the channel in case you did not do, because we'll upload all the videos which are related to the education, especially for children. Fine. Okay, let us start the topic now. Now compound interest. Generally, simple interest, we have seen the definition before a video. So that says interest is calculated uniformly on the original principle throughout the loan period. So for example, if I'll take 3 years loan period, some amount rupees 1000. So on this 1000, okay, at 8% rate of interest. Now 8% rate of interest on this 1000 rupees, every year same interest will be calculated for 3 years continuously. So one year first year interest, second year interest and third year interest also same. That's when you come to the simple interest. But when you come to the compound interest, every year interest will be added again in the principal. So every year interest will be added again in the principal, that will become again principal for the second year, because first year amount will be principal for the second year. So like that, every year will be included and added. So compound interest is final amount minus original principal, because final amount, because every year that amount will be different. So final amount minus the original principal. So I'll tell you some problems how to use this compound interest now to solve now. In this problem, you'll understand clearly what is the exact difference of compound interest and simple interest. See, question is here, find the amount and the compound interest. The compound interest and amount also need to find out on rupees 8000 at 5% per annum for 2 years. Compounded annually. So yearly they will calculate the interest. Now in this problem, amount and compound interest you need to find out. So first we'll find the interest for 1 year, then we'll carry this to the second year also. See how to solve. So given that the principal for the first year is 8000, right? Principal for the first year, because every time interest will be calculated. So first year is rupees 8000. Now again interest for first year. Interest for first year is nothing but that is a PTR by 100, but we take time is 1 year, every 1 year. So that is 8000 is principal for first year and rate of interest is 5 and first year is 1 year, because 1 every year will calculate by 100. Same simple interest formula only, but 1 year will take in the place of T. Okay, if you simplify, 80 into 5 is 8 5 40 10. So 400 rupees is interest for first year. Now amount at the end of the first year. So amount at end of, because principal first year is 8000 and interest for first year is 400. So amount at the end of first year, because after 1 year is over, then amount is equals to that 8000 plus this interest is 400. Now that is together is 8400. This is amount at the end of the first year. Now principal for the second year. So principal for second year. Now principal for second year is nothing but amount at the end of the first year. So both are same, that is same 8400. Okay, so this is the amount at the end of the first year. That amount at the end of the first year only becomes next year principal. There is a compound interest calculating bonus. Now interest for second year will find out. Interest for second year, that is same. Now PTR, because P is 8400, rate of interest is 5 and time is for 1 year, because second year, by 100, by calculating this 2 zeros, 84 into 5, 420. So this 420 rupees is interest for second year. Now amount at the end of the second year. Now amount at end of second year. So second year amount means second year interest and principal for second year, that is 8400 plus this 420. So we need to add this both, 8820. Okay, this is the amount at the end of the second year. Therefore finally amount is equals to, so because we are taking interest only for 2 years, so finally the amount, so this final amount is 8820. Now compound interest. Okay, compound interest is nothing but amount minus original principal. Okay, this final amount minus original principal. Original principal you should take. Now that is 8820 minus original principal is 8000. Because starting. Now 820. You subtract. 820 rupees is the compound interest. But simple interest will come is less than compound interest, because simple interest will be calculated same interest for all the years. So first year is 400. First year is 400, right? Same 400 will add for second year also. But compound interest means will be increased. So compound interest always greater than simple interest. So compound interest is 820 for 2 years. This for 2 years. Okay, if the problem is asked for 3 years, means again second year amount will be added in line with the interest. That amount again, the principal if add again, there will be amount for third year also will take. So you should continue the same problem. Okay, this for 2 years, 3 years means same, you can continue. Second year's interest also will be added, the amount at the end of the second year, that will be principal for third year. Okay, like that, how many years are given, that many years we can continue this system. Fine. Now in this small drawback is, for example, if the interest is for 10 years or 12 years, so for 12 times you need to do the same process. So instead of doing this much long, so if there is a formula for compound interest for directly to find out, I'll explain now. So we'll see deduction of formula for compound interest to find out directly instead of taking this many times adding interest. And let us see the deduction of formula for compound interest now. formula for compound interest. So first I'll write formula here. Compound interest after n years. After n years is equals to rupees. P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power N minus P. Okay, P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power N minus P. This is the formula for compound interest after N years. Okay, first I will tell you how this formula, okay, proof of this formula. So let sum of P be invented at R% per annum compounded annually. So let simple interest for 1 year, if its principal is P and rate of interest is R. Okay, principal is P and let take rate of interest is R% and compounded annually. So then sum of simple interest for 1 year. Simple interest for 1 year. We know that formula PTR by 100. So P for 1 year means time is equal to 1. That is PR by 100 because time is 1. Now amount after 1 year. So amount for 1 year. So after 1 year means that we need to add P plus PR by 100. Okay, if you take P common, 1 plus R by 100. Okay, this is amount for 1 year, amount after 1 year. Now let us take this, say some x. Let's say as x, equation 1. Now amount after, okay, simple interest for second year. Simple interest for second year, again PR by 100, but P is nothing but this x, because I am taking x, XR by 100. Then amount after 2 years, amount after 2 years, because simple interest for second year is x into r, because x is the amount after first year, that only as the principal for second year. That's what x plus xr by 100. Now if you take x common, 1 plus r by 100, but actually now you substitute the equation 1, x value in this. Now from 1 and 2, amount after second year, x is nothing but P into 1 plus R by 100 is x value, again into 1 plus R by 100 is there. Okay, substitution, x value is this one, this I substituted here. Then P into 1 plus R by 100 is 2 times, so 1 plus R by 100 all to the power 2. Okay, this is amount after 2 years. So similarly, now this amount becomes principal for 3rd year also. Similarly, 3rd year. So amount after 3 years. 3 years is P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power 3 will come. Okay, after 3 years means power 3. Then amount after n years, amount after n years, okay, that is P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power n, right? This is amount. So but we know compound interest is equals to amount minus original principal, right? Now amount is P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power n minus P is as is. Okay, this is compound interest formula for n years. When you take n, this way n years. So this formula will apply in the problems related to the compound interest to calculate the solution directly instead of taking every year interest is calculated. Okay, let us solve one or two sums first. Okay, this formula in use. Now find the amount of ₹12,000 for 3 years compounded annually at 10% per annum. Also find the compound interest. So find compound interest also. Fine. So if you observe this problem, it clearly says find the amount of 12,000. So 12,000 is the principal. So here P is equals to 12,000 for 3 years. So N is equal to 3. We will not take T here because for 3 years. So N is equal to 3 and R is given. Rate of interest is 10%. Okay, we need to find out the amount and compound interest. So amount formula is only P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. That is amount. So first we will find out the amount is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 all to the power n. So if you apply P into, that is 12,000 into 1 plus R is 10 by 100 all to the power 3. Okay, 12,000 1 plus 10 by 100. So this is 0, 1 by 10, that is 11 by 10 all to the power 3. Now we can simplify this, right? 12,000 into 11 by 10 power 3 means 11 by 10 3 times. Okay, 3 zeros, 10 table you can cancel here. So finally, 12 into 11 into 11 into 11. Okay, this if you multiply that will get the amount 15,972. So that is amount. Then we can find out the compound interest. So I am finding here. Therefore compound interest is equals to amount minus original principal. Now final amount is 15,972 minus the principal is 12,000. Subtract rupees 3,972. So this is the compound interest. Right. So we'll apply the formula directly. When the time is given, time you should take it as n. And by applying the formula of this, we'll get the compound interest directly. Otherwise, amount minus principal also compound interest only. Now, similarly, when you are finding using this formula, one important note I'll explain. So in this note, this what says is, in some case different rates are given in different years. Okay, for example, when the rate of interest, if it is coming different, so let principal is equals to P. Principal is rupees P and time 2 years. time is equals to 2 years, and but condition is let the rates of interest will be, now rates are R1% per annum during first year. So first year one rate and R2% per annum during second year. So 2 years, two different rates. Then how to find out the amount? Then amount is equals to amount after 2 years. So instead of taking separately, direct formula apply, that is P into 1 plus first year is R1%, so R1 by 100 into 1 plus second year is R2%, so R2 by 100, right? So this, if you solve, we'll get the amount after 2 years. Not only for 2 years, 3, 4 years, how many years is given also, we can use the same formula. So using this also, we can solve different sums. In the place of R1, R2, according to the given rates, this will apply. One sum I'll explain this method. Find the amount of rupees 25,000 after 2 years. So compounded annually only, by rate of interest being 8% per first year. 8% for first year and 9% per annum during the second year. 9% for second year. Okay, in this case, we need to find out the amount. Okay, so if observe, so amount after 2 years. Therefore, amount is equals to, so by applying the above formula, direct I'm writing, principal is 25,000. 25,000 into 1 plus R1 by 100. So 2 years total, but 8% first year, 9% second year. So 8 by 100 into 1 plus 9 by 100. Okay. This, if you simplify, you'll get the amount after 2 years. So that is 25,000 into 100 plus 8, 108 by 100 into 109 by 100. This is the value we need to solve. So you can cancel two zeros. 10. 5 table, 5 2s are, 5 5s are, again 2 1s are, 254s. So this all you can multiply, that is 5 into 54 into 109. So this is the amount. So if you multiply, that is 29,000, 5 into 54 into 109, 29,430. Okay, this is the amount. So if they asked to find out compound interest, after 2 years means this amount, 29,430 minus the given principal is 25,000. Okay, that is 430 rupees is the compound interest. So this is the way, whenever they are given two different rates, so we can solve the problem easily by using this above formula. Fine. Next, I'll show you some more problems related to the problems on population and depreciation. Okay, when the population is increasing or decreasing, how to find out? In this depreciation also, we can find out using a similar formula. So we'll solve two problems related to that now. Okay, here we'll solve problems on population and depreciation. So whenever the value is increasing, we'll use some formulas, and when the value is decreased also, we'll apply the same similar formula which is using for compound interest. So I'll explain directly two problems. One is on population, one is on depreciation, how it changes. Okay, let me write question. You'll see here the population of a certain town. So by understanding this problem, we'll see how to solve the remaining questions also. The population of a certain town was 4,55,625. Okay, in the year 2015. So in the year 2015, this is the population. Now it increases. It increases at the rate of 8% every year. Every year it is increasing at the rate of 8%. Now so first one, what would be its population in the year 2017? So in 2017, what is the population? At the same time, what was its population in the year 2013? Okay, what will be the population 2017 and what was the population in the year 2013? Okay. These two we need to solve. Okay, first of all, the population of the certain town is this. That means in the year 2015. Okay. So first of all, right, population in the year 2015. In the year 2015 is equals to 4,55,625, and increasing rate, so rate of increase here, so rate of increase is equals to 8% per annum. Okay, every year 8% the population is increasing. Now this is a given data first of all. So as per the first problem, according to the first question, population in the year 2017 means the population after 2 years, right? 2015 is given, 16 and 17. So population in the 2017, population in the year 2017, so that is nothing but population after 2 years. Okay, population after 2 years. After 2 years means we'll use a formula. That is p into 1 plus r by 100 whole power n is enough, so 2 times. So we can write here like this. First of all, value is 4,55,625 into how much rate is increasing? 8%. That is 1 plus 8 by 100 whole to the power 2. Because for 2 years it is. Now this, if we solve, we'll get the population in the year 2017. 4,55,625 into 8 by 100. That is 108 by 100. Two times. So 108 by 100. So you can simplify this. You can cancel 25, 27. Okay, 5 table. 7 and 25. So by canceling with this everything, you'll get finally 5,31,441. So by calculating, this is the population in the year 2017. So it's increased 5,31,441. Now, hence the population of 2017 would be 5,31,441. Now, population in the year 2013 also we need to find out. So this is actually 2 years back. So that since we don't know that, we'll take like this. Let the population in the year 2013 be X. Let the population, okay, this is the value for 2017, not 2013, you need to find out. So don't use minus, you need to use this like this. Population, let the population in year 2013 be take some x. Now from 2013 to 15 is increased, then population in 2015, then population in 2015 is nothing but from 2013 to 2 years you should add, that is 2013 is x into 1 plus increasing rate is same 8%, 8 by 100 all to the power 2. Okay, this is population in 2015, but we know already population in 2015. Right, that is according to the given 455,625. That is equal to x into 1 plus 8 by 100. That is 108 by 100 into 108 by 100. From this, if you find out the value of x, that will be, it was the population 2013. Okay, cancellations. 425. Again, from this x is equals to, take all right hand values left side, 455,625 into reciprocal 25 by 27 into 25 by 27. Now this value, if we simplify, that is 455,625 into 25 is 625 by 27 into 27, 729. This after cancellations, so finally get 390,625. So it was the population 2013. Okay, this is the way we can find the solutions whenever it's regarding the population problems. Now we'll see one more question which are related to depreciation. A machine is bought for 180,400. Its value depreciates at the rate of 10% per annum. Okay, find the value after 2 years. Now values depreciates. So when values depreciates, value of the machine after 2 years. So we'll use the minus one, data and writing problem. So value of the machine. So value of the machine after 2 years. So it's decreasing every year. So after 2 years is, now present is 180,400. So 180,000 is present into, and 10% is decreasing for 2 years. That means 1 - 10/100 power 2. Okay. This we need to simplify. Whenever the depreciates, you should use minus. So 180,400 into 1 - 1/10. That is 9/10 power 2. So into 9/10. Okay, 2 zeros, 10, so you can cancel. Then 1804 into 9 is 81. Now if you multiply, this is the value after 2 years. That is, okay, multiply 146,124. So whenever the value is depreciates, you need to use the minus here, 1 - depreciate % by 100 all to the power n. So n is nothing but number of years. So this is the way we can solve the problems which is related to the population or depreciation. Now this all, the previous also we have seen compounded annually. Now next we will see how to find out the compound interest when interest is compounded half yearly, and followed by we will see when interest is compounded quarterly also. I'll solve the problems now. So here, how to find out the compound interest when interest is compounded half yearly. So half yearly means every half year, means every 6 months, that interest will be added in the principal. Again, it will be counted. So every half year only that interest will be calculated. So let us see the problem. So before seeing the problems, we'll see the formula, how to prepare the formula for compound interest when interest is compounded half yearly. First of all, let principal be P. Okay, principal is equals to P, and rate is equals to R%. This is the given data, so they'll give the question per annum. Rate is per annum, and time is equal to given as n years. Now when you come to the compounded half yearly means, then principal will not change, the same. Then principal, that is same, rupees P only, and rate is R%, but when you compounded half yearly, it will be half of that, that is R by 2% per half year. Okay, now time is equals to actually n years means how many half years in n years is 2n half years, because every year 2 half years, so n years means 2n half years. So 2n half years, for example 3 years means 3 into 2, 6 half years will come time. So based on this, we can make the formula for amount. So amount is equals to, now P into one plus R by R is nothing but R by 2. So R by 2 by 100. So R by 2 into 100 power previous is n but now 2n. Okay, R becomes R by 2 and n becomes 2n. Same amount formula only, compound interest, but formula will be changed like this. This is when compounded half yearly, we will apply this formula. This formula will use in this problems whenever they asked for compound interest compounded off yearly. Okay, let us solve the problems now. So one question is here, find the compound interest on rupees 1,25,000 at 12% per annum for 1.5 years compounded half yearly. Okay, this is the important, what they are asking, compounded annually or compounded half yearly. So this is the important, we need to check the problem whenever the given question. Okay, here compounded half yearly, so we should use this formula for compounded half yearly. Now principal is equals to 1,25,000 and R is equals to 12%, so 12 per annum and n is equal to 1.5 years. This is R percent. Now n is equals to 1.5 years. So 1.5 years is nothing but how many halves? So 3 halves. So 2 and 2 plus 1, 3 by 2. So actually 3 by 2 years. So 3 by 2 years means 3 half years. Okay, in the place of n, we'll ask this, you can take 3 by 2. Now p is 1,25,000, r is 12, n is equal to 3 by 2. We'll substitute in this problem directly. So amount is equals to second formula, p is 1,25,000 into 1 plus R by R is 12 by 2 into 100. So I am applying formula in the place of R, 12 power 2 into N. N is 3 by 2. Okay, next step 2 to get cancelled. That is equal to 3 will come because 1.5 means 3 half years. Then 1,25,000 0 into, we can do cancellations, 2 ones are 2, 6. So 106 by 100 all to the power 3. And this, if you solve, use cancellations, 50 53 is a 2 table. So 1,25,000 into 53 by 50 power 3. So 53 by 50 3 times. This directly, if you solve, we'll get the answer 1,48,877. You can use calculator. The calculations also show you once. Here 3 zeros 10s are cancelled. 5 ones are 5 2s are 10, 25s are. Again 5 ones are 5. So this will denominator will be cancelled. So numerator is 53 into 53 into 53 is 1,48,877. Clear? So this is the amount. Now compound interest is amount minus principal. So amount is 1,48,877 minus principal is 1,25,000. That is a given. That is 23,877. Hence, the compound interest after 1.5 years is 23,877. This way you can solve this. So one more problem I will show you. Okay, similar compounded half year and so on. Find the compound interest. Find the compound interest on 1,60,000 here. 1 rupees, 1,60,000 at 10% per annum for 2 years. So compounded half yearly. So compounded half yearly. This is mentioned. So now we can solve. So direct I am taking here p value is 1,60,000 and r is equals to 10% and n is equals to 2 years. So because of compounded half yearly, the amount is equals to formula p into 1 plus r by 2 into 100 with power 2n. This is a formula. So apply the values. 1,60,000 into 1 plus r by, that is 10 by 2 into 100 power 2 into n. So 2 into n is 2. Now when I require to simplify this, 2 ones are 2, 5. Again 5 ones are 5, 20. So 1,60,000 into 1 plus 1 by 20. So that is 21 by 20. Power 2 into 2 is 4. What is the power 4? Now this, if you simplify, 1,60,000 into 21 by 20 all to the power 4. So 4 times 21 by 20, 21 by 20 into 21 by 20. And this we need to solve to get the value. Here 2 table, 10 table for 4 zeros. 4 zeros you can cancel. 2 ones are 2 eights, 2 ones are 2 fours are. Again, we have 2 2s are 4 and 4 1s are cancelled. Now, 21 into 21 into 21. So, all if you multiply. So, 1,94,481. So, this is the amount. Now, based on this, we will find out the compound interest also. Therefore, compound interest is equals to amount minus principal. So amount is 1,94,481 minus principal is 1,60,000. Subtract this both, we get 34,481. So this is the compound interest. So this is the way we can solve the problems when the questions are related to the compounded half yearly. So this is the formula we will apply. Now next we will see when how to find out the compound interest when interest is compounded quarterly. Okay, if you understood this, next quarterly is very easy. I will explain now with including two problems. Now here how to find out the compound interest when interest is compounded quarterly. So quarterly means every quarter year the interest will be added in the principal. So how many quarter years in a year? Okay, so we have 12 months in 1 year, 12 months. So quarter means divide by 4. So 12 divided by 4 is equals to 3. So every 3 months we are making as one quarter year. So for every 3 months the interest will be added in the principal. So let us see the formula and we can see the problems which are related to compounded quarterly. Let principal is equals to P. Okay, first in every question they'll give the principal that I'm taking as P. So let principal is equals to rupees P. Rate is equals to R percent. Rate is equals to R percent per annum. Okay, per annum the rate is given and time. So time is equals to n years. So time they will give in the problem in years. N years. So if they will give data like this, now to convert into compounded quarterly. Then the principal will be P itself. Principal is not changed. So principal is the same P. And rate, this is quarterly, so 4 times should be reduced, so 1/4, that means r by 4%. For example, if they'll give 8% means 8 by 4, so only 2% per quarter. So r by 4% per quarter year. And time will be, so every 1 year we have 4 quarter years. Okay, every n years means n into 4, so 4n quarters, because 4 if it is 3 years, 3 into 4, so 12 quarters. If it is a 2 years means 2 into 4, so 8 quarters. Like that time will be 4n. Now based on this we can write the formula for amount. Now amount is equals to rupees, same P into, so P is not changed, 1 plus rate becomes r by 4, that is r by 4 by 100. So 100 is asked is all to the power number of years. This number of quarters is 4n. Yeah, this is the formula we will use for compounded quarterly. So in compounded quarterly, so this is the formula we need to use. Okay, how to solve the problems and explain two sums here now. Now find the compound interest. Find the compound. Find the compound interest on rupees 20,000 at 12% per annum for 6 months. Compounded quarterly. So compounded quarterly is given. So there is a main here. So compounded quarterly. So quarterly formula apply. Now given data here. P is given, principal, that is 20,000, and rate is 12% per annum, and n is equals to 6 months. Okay, n is equal to 6 months only. So 6 months means how many quarters? If you convert into years, 6 by 12 is years. So quarters is 4. Now that is 4 ones are 4, 3, and 3 ones are 3, 2s are. Finally, 2 quarters. How many times that interest will be repeated? That is, you can take it as n place. So 2 quarters. Now, based on this information, you can do the problem. Now, rate of interest should be reduced into 4. Okay. Now, R is also is changing. 12 by 4. 12 by 4 is 3% per quarter. Now, amount is equals to. So principal is 20,000 into 1 plus rate of interest is for quarter is 3 by 100, because 12 by 4 is also 3 only. So that I am making all to the power 4n. So previous all we did, 4 into n is 6 by 12, that is 2. So that we solved here. So this is solution of the 4n. N is 6 by 12 into 4, so 2 quarters. So we need to reduce this problem. That is 20,000 into 1 plus 3 by 100. So 103 by 100 into 103 by 100. So simplify this. So cancellations. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros, because 100 hundreds are 10,000. Cancel. So 2 into 103 into 103. 2 into 103 is 206 into 103. That is the total amount, rupees 21,000 by multiplying 218. 21,218 rupees is amount. Now, if you can find out the compound interest. So, compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. So, amount is 21,218 minus principal is 20,000. Fine, that is the remaining is 1,218. 218 is a compound interest. Hence, required compound interest is rupees 1218. So 1218. Let us solve one more sum, which is related to the compounded quarterly. Find the compound interest. Find the compound interest on rupees 128,000 for 9 months at 10% per annum. Okay, compounded quarterly. So compounded quarterly. Therefore, year interest is on 1,28,000. So this is the principal. Now principal is 1,28,000, and rate of interest is 10%. But according to quarter, 10 by 4% per quarter. Okay, that is 5 by 2% per quarter. Now time is given in months, so 9 months. 9 months means number of quarters is 3 quarters, because 9 by 12 is in years into 4, that is 4n. You can cancel 4 ones are 4, 3s are 3, 1s are 3, 3s. So 3 quarters. So now based on this data we can apply the formula. Therefore amount is equals to principal, that is 1,28,000 into 1 plus r by 100. So r is 5 by 2 by 100 all to the power number of quarters, that is 3. Okay, 3 times should be repeated. Now let us solve this. So we can solve 1,28,000 into 5 by 2 into 100. So 5 ones are 5 20s. So 1 plus 1 by 40, all to the power 3. So 1,28,000 into 1 plus 1 by 40 is 41 by 40, all to the power 3. So power 3 is 3 times. 1,28,000 into 41 by 40 into 41 by 40 into 41 by 40. Okay, right, 3 times. Now by simplifying, cancelling, 10 table 3 times, 3 table here get cancel. 128, 4 ones are 432. Is it 12? 2 is 8. Again 4 table, 4 ones are 8 some. Again 4 ones are 4, 2 some. Now what is left? 2 into 41 into 41 into 41. So 2 into 41 is 82 into 41 into 41. So by multiplying these three numbers, we will get the total amount. Okay, by using calculation, 82 into 41 into 41. So 1,37,842. So this is the amount calculated on quarterly. Then you can find out the compound interest. Therefore compound interest is equals to amount minus principal. 1,37,842 is total amount compounded quarterly for 9 months, then principal is 1,28,000. So by doing this, subtracting, you get 9,842. So this is the compound interest calculated for 9 months. So only we need to change the p value is fixed, r value, t value only have to change according to the given problem, either compounded quarterly or half yearly, annual, like that. Right, so this way we can solve the compound interest problems. So I said earlier we have some other questions also are available and solutions, including according to your textbook, you'll find out the other solutions also, not only maths, other subjects, even other chapters. So in this website, so just to go through this and find out the another material for freely. Fine, subscribe the channel. We'll upload only the videos which are related for students in case you did not. Fine, thank you for watching. Have a nice time.